information in the pistol event. The 10 is not normal, it's a really good shot. There will be also shot many 9s. So you could get an advance very fast here in this final, because if you see a 9.4, this means that the shot is not near by the 10, but better than on the border of the 9. A 9.1 is better, 9.9 would be better. Here in the final, the result after the dot is counting. In the pre-event, it doesn't matter if you shot a 9.0 or 9.9, it's a 9. The same as 10 and so on. But here in the final, everything counts.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome here in Munich, Germany at the 1972 Olympic Games shooting range. We're here for 50-meter air pistol men, and I'm Hillary Russell. I have the pleasure of having Trinidad and Tobago's air pistol shooter, Roger Daniel, here with us. Roger, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Hillary. Thank you for having me here.
Now, tell us a little bit about how you're progressing.
Hi, my progression has been a challenging one. It's been going good so far. A bit tiring right now, I'm really a bit burnt out, but if you want to get the scores or you want to get the successes, you really have to push yourself even a lot harder. But coming up to the games, you don't want to be too burnt out, but you should peak at the right moment.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And so you'll be going to the games, is that right?
God's alive, yes.
The first time?
Oh, no, this will be my third time. The first time was when I now started. Mm-hmm. The second time I was getting to know them, and I think the third time there should be a medal with my name on it.
That's wonderful. That's great. God, I wish you the very best. Here are eight finalists, and I'll have a chance to introduce them to you.
A lot of experience today.
Yes, a lot. In eighth place with 583 points, representing the Ukraine, we have Oleg Omelchek.
Yeah, very experienced guy. He should be a guy to watch too as well, because as you can see, he's settling in, and he's settling very good.
And he actually entered in after a three-way shoot-off for 7th and 8th place. Then in 7th place with 583 points, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Zhang Tian.
Yes, and again, this guy here, he's been proven time and time again to watch. And this is going to be a very interesting final, especially with these two guys at the back, coming up on the back. I think it'll be a great time. Yeah.
Then in 6th place with 584 points, representing the Russian Federation, we have Vladimir Isakov.
Yeah, I call him the father of the sport. No, he's a great guy. He's a great shooter. I mean, I had all started watching him from when I started shooting, and a lot of experience. So, like I said, these are the guys we have to watch.
Okay. And in 5th place, coming in with 585 points, representing the Ukraine, we have Denis Kuznirov.
Hi, this is, and he's 19 years of age. It's amazing that he has such a future ahead of him, and we could expect great things from him.
Absolutely. He just won the bronze medal in London, so we have to keep an eye on this one, I think. And in 4th place, with 586 points, representing Turkey, we have Josef Diket.
Yes, he's a great shooter. A gentleman that I've always admired too, his calmness. You see, he's the most calmest guy I've seen in a long time.
Then in 3rd place, coming with 586 points, representing Spain, we have Pablo Carrera.
Yes, I think this is his first final as well.
Yes.
So let's see if he can hold it and concentrate and give these guys a run for it.
Okay. And in 2nd place, with 589 points, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Tan Zhongliang.
Yes, again, a lot of experience, a lot of composure. This guy has been around a lot, and he's made finals over and over, and he could give them a good shot at it too as well. He's a great shooter.
Then in 1st place, coming with 590 points, representing the Republic of Korea, we have Yong Ho Jin.
Again, world record holder. Let's see him do his stuff today again.
Okay. He's been having a really great season, without a doubt. And how many points do we have here separating 1st from 8th?
Yes.
We have 6 points. We have 7 points for
separating. Yeah. So it should be very interesting.
And so tell us a little bit about you and what you do to train. What is your daily training?
My daily training... Well, I can't go into details. It's kind of so lengthy. But what I would say is, I get up. We do usual thing. You know, you say your prayers. You go. The coach says, okay. Sometimes you do physicals. Sometimes you don't do physicals. According to what the program entails, you can go straight to the range. You start your preparation. You warm up. And then you start to do the program that the coach has for you.
Okay.
And then you start the program. When it's finished, you do your physicals. Or we may talk, or we may recap how the day's events go. Mm-hmm. And you do this on a daily basis.
Okay.
Depending on what it is you have to do.
So more or less, do you train 7 days a week?
Oh, no. No. Not that. I wish, but the coach wouldn't allow me to.
No, of course not. And do you have a job outside of shooting?
Or? Oh, yes, I'm in the military as well.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like
most of these guys are, exactly.
I have a military background, so that was how I began shooting in the first place. But I usually use the 9mm caliber.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I started with IPSC, and these are the fast events that have your heart rate going very high. So I started at these events, and that's when you know I'm starting to settle in with the air pistol and free pistol.
And you said you started about 10 years ago, is that right?
Yes, 10 years ago.
Okay. And you've loved it ever since the first day.
Oh, I love it with a passion.
Good. That's wonderful. And you're going to be going off to the Olympic Games, and that's really exciting. I mean, I think it must put a lot of pressure on you, between it being exciting and being unnerving.
But not really, actually. After the first time, it was really nerving, and the second time, I was understanding. I was beginning to understand what it is to be at the Olympic Games, and I think the third time would make a difference. So I just need to pay attention to details, concentrate, and just do what I have to do.
And just do your best.
Yes, that's true.
That's
give
all.
It the best that you can give on the day, because shooting is a sport that anything can happen on a given day.
That's true. That is absolutely true. And it is quite a venue there in London. We've seen that during the pre-event.
The temperature was unbelievable.
This is what I think everyone has come away from the London Games, and this is all that they can talk about.
Yeah,
not if there was a new world record set or a final. No, it's always the weather.
What? It was freezing for me.
I'm sure you must have just been absolutely freezing.
Oh man, I miss the beach.
Oh, so it looks like we're going to get this final started in just a couple seconds. And we're going to just focus in first on Omelchuk and Zhang. These are the two guys that came into the final after the three-way shoot-off.
Two, one, stop.
There you can see them feeling out. This is the time that gongs.
And the first few shots are the ones that are the most unnerving, I've been told.
Yes, yeah. the first and the last.
And the last.
Oh, yes.
Especially now, because you know where you're standing. You know, we've got monitors in front of the men, as well as the announcer saying exactly where they're standing. And so there's a 9.8 for Zhang.
Zhang.
And a 9.6 for Omelchuk.
I know that the mind seems to be going to be wondering, okay, am I really in position? Yeah, am I positioned properly? Okay, you analyze. They're going to be analyzing a lot right about now. When the first shot gets really picked, you know, you really have to fight within yourself to settle as quickly as possible, because in the blink of an eye, you could lose this.
Just waiting now for Isakov.
Experience.
Mm-hmm. With a 9.4.
Oh, okay.
So let's take a look here at the standings after Jin shot a 9.4, Tan a 9.8, Carrera 10.4, Diketz a 10.8,
yes,
nice, Kuzhnirov a 9.8, Isakov a 9.4, Zhang a 9.8, and Omelchuk a 9.6. Jin is still holding on to first place by 6/10 of a point, and then in third place we have Diketz. Only 4/10 of a point behind him is Carrera.
Like I said, this is just the beginning. So.
And you can see on the first shot, more or less the scores that we've got. As you were saying, the first shot and the last shot are the hardest.
Yeah, no, you would actually see them starting to settle in after the first shot is analyzed. I would say after the second shot. After the second shot, most likely you would tend to see who is settling in.
Mm-hmm.
Quick and who is now still trying to reassess themselves. So you're going to see on this second shot here now, you're going to see people really pushing it now. They're going to pay more attention. They're going to check themselves.
And here, as you said, the father of shooting Isakov going up against Kuznirov. Yeah. You know, these are two, you know, this is like
a junior,
junior and, you know, the senior shooter, 19-year-old. This is very great. Isakov with a 10.2. And Kuznirov a 10.2 as well. Nice. Yeah, very nice.
10.3.
So let's take a look here. We have Jin, who shot a 10.3. Tan, a 10.1. Carrera, a 9.1. Dikets shooting really strong, a 10.7. Kuznirov, a 10.2. Isakov, also 10.2. Zhang, a 10.3. And Olmashek, a 10.8.
That's what it went almost a perfect round.
And Jin now is ahead by 8/10 of a point.
Not much at all. Not much at all.
And we have Dikets is putting the pressure on. He's only 1.4 tenths of a point behind Tan.
He's going to be coming settled.
Yes, I think so. And let me just take a look at him.
Dikets,
he won the World Cup final bronze last year. After winning the gold medal in the Munich, the World Cup in Munich, so he's got it in him, definitely.
Yes, definitely. He has the experience. He has the, like I say, he's the most coolest guy I've seen.
He is very calm and cool. Yeah. So let's focus in now on Dikets and Carrera.
Well done, great shot.
Very well done. 10.7 for Carrera.
That must feel relieved.
9.6 for Dikets.
Results after the third final.
Okay,
shot,
so let's take a look at the results. We have Jin, who shot a 10.0. Tan, a 10.4. Carrera, a 10.7. Dikets, a 9.6. Kuznirov, a 10.6. Isakov, a 10.4. Zhang, a 9.9. And Olmashek, a 9.6. The standings are still the same. Jin's in first place, but he's losing his lead.
Yeah,
it's getting chewed away a little bit here. He's 4/10 of a point ahead, and we have Dikets now in third place, 2.2 tenths of a point behind Tan. But Carrera is now putting the pressure on as well. He's almost a point away from him.
That creates even more tension, especially if you're a shooter. If they listen to the scores, I always recommend that you don't listen to anything. You just try to stay focused and be in your own little world, you know. But it's gotten very tight now as we go along. Like I say, still have a few more shots to go.
Oh, yeah. And we're just going to focus in on Tan and Jin right now.
Two at the top.
Two at the top is right. Number one, number two. Nine point eight for Tan, and a 10.0 for Jin.
Stop. It's gonna still feel kind of comfortable, not much by not by Jin, much, but still.
We have Jin with a 10.0, Tan a 9.8, Carrera a 10.3, Dikets a 9.6. Kuznirov a 10.1, Isakov a 10.0, Zhang a 10.3, and Olmashek a 9.7. Jin has taken up a little bit more of his lead. He's 6/10 of a point now in the lead over Dan. Dikets is still in third place, but only 2/10 of a point behind him is Carrera.
Oh, Carrera's holding it good.
Yeah.
Actually, this is his first final like this, and he's holding his head. So I would think that he would be settling in because watching his pattern, you can see that he's actually now settling in into it. Like I say, more shots to go. So
that's right. We're now on to shot five. And here he is, Carrera, who has never entered into a final round of a World Cup, and he's just proving that we should be really watching him closely.
He should make his mark now. See the swing.
Mm-hmm. A little bit unsteady there. Yeah. That's probably the smartest thing to do at this point.
Yes, I agree. I could tell you.
That's why you're here sitting next to me, so you can tell me how it feels, huh?
Yeah. It's like deep in concentration. You just, sometimes you're not even aware of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're so into concentrated, but you have to be, you have to learn to feel everything around you.
And there's a 9.4.
Stop.
Okay, let's take a look again here. We have Jin with 10.4, Khan a 9.5, Carrera we saw a 9.4, Dikatz a 10.2, Kuznirov a 9.6, Izakov a 10.2, Zhang a 10.7, and Olmachuk a 10.4. Jin now has a point and a half above Tan. Dikatz is now 1.7 tenths of a point behind Tan, and Carrera now is a point behind.
They're almost like the same standing as they started, except for the third position. Carrera and Dikatz are just changing places there.
Now, before Mr. Dikatz, he changed. No, he's on the position. But if the Carrera is behind, now 1 point.
Yeah, that's right. And we're halfway through the final now. We've got five more shots to go. Yeah, Roger, anything can happen, as we know and we've seen.
True, very true.
Three, two, one.
But usually they say after the fifth shot you should be settling in and should be flowing, but you can never tell with the nerves and the tension and the heart beating. It's all about being composed.
Here he is, Dikatz.
Look at the concentration.
And he doesn't wear any type of headgear, nothing to do. 10.0.
Great sounds after the
sixth
final shot. Jin,
10.6. 8.9 for Tan. Whoa.
That's gonna affect him.
That certainly is going to. We've got Jin with a 10.6. The unfortunate 8.9 for Tan. Carrera, a 10.3. Dikatz, a 10.0. Kuznirov, a 9.9. Izakov, a 10.6. Zhang, also a 10.6. And Olmachuk, a 10.4. Wow, with that 10.6, Jin now has 3.2 tenths of a lead.
Whoa.
Yes, but Dikatz is putting the pressure on now. He's 6 tenths of a point behind, and Carrera now is 7 tenths of a point behind Tan.
Whoa, it's really getting more interesting.
It certainly is. And we still have 4 more shots to go. What is your feeling about Jin? Do you think that he can more or less bag the gold?
Yes, I believe so. He's a guy who has been in this position many times, and he has shown from time and time again, once he starts smooth and he flows, he takes it.
Okay.
But if you see he has any waviness, then you know he's in some problems. And then, but anytime he flows smooth like this, he always takes it.
Okay.
But let's see again, it's any day how you feel on the day.
That's right.
So let's see.
Focusing in now on Dikatz and Tan. Tan coming off of an 8.6. With a 9.9.
I know the mind may be going, I'm very busy. If you stick a monitor on him, test his mental heat temperature.
10.3 and a 10.0 for Jin.
10.0.
So Jin with 10.0, Tan a 9.9, Carrera a 10.1, Dikatz a 10.3. We have Kuznirov with a 10.3 as well. 10.3 seems like it's a good number this time. Also Izakov a 10.3. Zhang a 10.1 and Olmachuk a 9.4. With that 10.3, Dikatz has now really putting the pressure on Tan. He's only 2 tenths of a point away. And 3.3 points lead we have Jin over Tan.
Carrera is holding on still there in the same position.
That's right.
Mr. Carrera, now again.
And we've got three more shots to go.
Difference to the bronze medal.
Let's just see if Dikatz can keep putting the pressure on.
Yes.
You know, it'd be great to see him getting the silver medal.
Attention.
Tall man, as calm as he is, as you referred to him, very calm and quiet.
Yeah, he is. The concentration on the faces.
10.1
for Tan.
Ooh, 10.5 for Dikatz.
Closing
this
in more.
I think it's going to change the standings. It could very easily. We'll have to take a look.
It's going to be very close.
9.5 for Jin. He's got some room for error here. So
he does.
Izakov, who's just shooting very consistently here.
He's settling in nice.
10.0.
Oh, wow. That is the series. The series.
So let's take a look here. We've got Jin with a 9.5, Tan with a 10.1, Carrera 9.5. Diketz has now overtaken Tan with a 10.5. Kuznirov, an unfortunate 8.5.
Oh, that's going to hurt him.
Isakov, a 10.0. Zhang, a 9.5. And Olmachuk, a 9.9. Like we were just saying, with that 10.5, Diketz has overtaken Tan. He's ahead now by 0.2 of a point.
Yes, he's strong. He's settling. He's really settling. And he's moving.
Yes, he is. He entered in fourth place and now is up into second place. And we still have Jin with 2.5 points lead.
Yes. Two more shots to go.
Yeah.
So let's see. Next competition shot, love.
Attention. 3, 2, 1, stop.
And here he is, Jong Ho Jin, who is currently holding on to first place by 2.5 points.
Next move.
Nice. 10.4. 9.4 for Tan. He's not happy with that.
Yeah, he's not.
At 10.4 for Diketz. It's very hard to read his reaction to see if he's happy or not.
You could never tell this guy. I always watch him and he's like, cool, Mr. Cool.
Yeah, yeah.
He is.
Again,
have
now.
The experience.
Isakov at 8.7. You could see
the flinch. Like,
yep, his hand was shaking just a bit there.
Stop.
He didn't hear because he's not pleased about that. He's definitely not pleased about that.
10.4.
So we've got Jin with a 10.4, Tan with a 9.4, Carrera a 9.5. Diketz at 10.4, Kuznirov an 9.8, Isakov at the unfortunate 8.7. Zhang a 9.8 and Olmachuk a 9.7. And with that 10.4, Diketz says is moving ahead. Yes, he's only he's 1.2.
It's down to the final shot that will depict where you are.
Exactly.
I always said the first and the last shot.
And this is what we've been seeing, you know, all this year, just the last shot. You think you know where everybody's standing, who's going to win the gold, then bam, something happens and everything's been upset.
Let's see here now.
Yeah, let's take a look again on Jin. It still has 2.5 points lead above the others.
Should be settling in very, should be comfortable with this one.
Yeah, 10.5, the gold is definitely his, without a doubt.
Let's see, Tan.
Tan with a 10.0. Oh, Diketz an 8.4 to finish off.
You see, the same thing we were just saying.
Exactly, just exactly what we were saying.
Unloaded. The same thing, it isn't over until the final shot.
But he did get the bronze medal, even with that 8.4. Here is our gold medalist, Jong Ho Jin of the Republic of Korea, winning yet another gold medal. Really just showing that he's extremely talented, a very talented shooter. Let's see if we can take a look at our silver medalist now.
Like we just said, the last shot, the final shot of the competition.
That's right.
Send over till it's over.
And our silver medalist, Tan Zhengliang. From the People's Republic of China, winning the silver on the last
shooters. They're all great shooters.
Really great shooters. And Josef Diketz winning the bronze.
He may be disappointed with that, but...
But he's still on the podium.
Still, yeah, he's
exactly.
Still on the podium.
So there he is. Josef Diketz winning the bronze medal. Good smile on his face. It looks like he's got some good sportsmanship. Oh, so it's been a really, really great final. And Roger, I want to wish you the very best of luck at the Olympic Games.
Thank
go
you
for
very
it.
Much. Thank you. Thank you. I'll go with your words.
Okay. All right. Take good care. And like I said, wish you the best.
Thank you very much. And thanks for having me here.
It's been a pleasure.
Okay. Thank you. Have a good job.
10-meter air pistol men. The medals will be presented by Mr. Willy Grill, Germany ISSF Committee. And the bronze medal goes with a total score of 686.5 points from Turkey to Yusuf Dikeç. Silver medal goes with a total score of 686.9 points, representing the People's Republic of China, to Tan Songling. With a total score of 691.1 points, representing Korea, to Jong Oh Jin. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Korea.